Now it's time for Mavis and all the gang. And this week, well, Mavis and Phyllis and everyone else are talking tears and making preparations to put on a Christmas show of their own during the virus.
Hello, dears. It's time once again to talk all about how that was during the virus. Now, like Dilla's next door always used to say when she see children playing, that'll all end in tears. And that's what's happened. That Boris and all them lot soon announced towards the end of lockdown too that the whole country has ended up in tears. Would you believe it? Suffolk is going to be in tier two. I know, Phyllis, but them's the rules. We can still go down the pub soon, as long as we have a proper meal with our drinks, because the coronas won't come if that's dinner time. Well, we shall have to rethink all the plans we had coming up for Christmas time, with all them locked down away. Originally, Doris said about going all the way to London to go and see a play. I know, we've got to stay here. But I reckon we could just put on a play ourselves. We done a bit of am-dram a few years ago. Yeah. See, Phyllis don't like to be seen, so she was backstage as the prompt when people forget their lines. But even when they forgot the lines, they still couldn't hear what they were. Remember when you prompted Gladys when we were doing Agatha Christie's Murder at the Vicarage? She came straight out of character, stormed into the wings to read the script herself. And then everyone had to wait and be still, except for Dillis, who then started eating all the prop biscuits. Yeah, that's fun though, isn't it? We could do it outside, like them outspoken theatre lot in Haverhill do when they do a Shakespeare. I should like to do a Shakespeare or a sonnet. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Oh, Phyllis, I know you're not keen on the bard. Phyllis? Thou art a very ragged wart. Well, how about Dickens? You like a drop of Dickens, didn't you? All them wonderful characters. Bill Sykes, Uriah Heep, Bob Cratchit. I say, I'll suggest it to all them lot when we do our Zoom that we could do a Christmas carol. You could be the ghost of Christmas future. You don't have to say nothing. You'd just be covered up in a blanket pointing at staff. Well, let's get on the Zoom. Look, Doris has sent a link. Dillis is already in the waiting room. Let's have a look now. There she is. Doris is waving, but it looks like she's just going to listen while she makes sausage rolls. Hello, Dillis.
Hello, Mavis. Hello, Phyllis. Yep.
Oh, and Gladys.
Hello, Dillis. I finally got it working on the Zoom.
Yep. Here come Joan and Horace. Whatever are they? I don't think they realise the mic is on.
She thinks she's all high and mighty now that she do all that stuff on the wireless with that Georgie Jameson.
Hello, Joe.
Oh, you're right, Mavis.
Yeah. Now, me and Phyllis were just thinking we could all do a lovely outdoor play for everyone of a Christmas carol.
Oh, that'd be good, yeah.
Well, that sounds like ever so much fun.
Well, I shall definitely be part of that, Mavis. Will you, Horace?
No, I bloomin' well shan't.
Oh.
We're going down the garden.
Well, and Doris has given a thumbs up. This could be exciting. I should like to be the narrator. Marley was dead to begin with. Dillis, you can be screwed. I think we might need to get a few more people involved. Yep, watch this space.
Humbug!
Yep.
Mavis and Phyllis and all the gang during the virus. And indeed, yes, watch this space. I can feel a Christmas special coming on.